Hello, this is Mark from My Keys to Music. Thanks for joining me on this video. Got some exciting news. The Nord Sound Manager version 9 just hit the streets here on July 4th, 2024, Independence Day here in the US. This particular sound manager is almost revolutionary in a way because it's going to save you some time on your setup and your configuration of your Nord keyboard in one significant way. And that is the whole idea of you having to go to the Nord website and manually download either a piano or a sample and manage it where it goes on your computer and where you store it and keeping track of it all, then opening up the Nord Sound Manager and then bringing it into the Nord Sound Manager, then eventually getting it to your keyboard. And at that point, it's just sort of a clunky, lots of different steps involved. This new way is going to be much better because you'll start with the Nord Sound Manager and then work your way backwards. The Nord Sound Manager has a direct connection into the Nord Cloud, into Nord Never Neverland. The Nord Library and the Nord Sample Library, the Nord Pianos and Samples, are available directly in the Nord Sound Manager, which means I can see the complete list without having to go to the website. All sizes and everything. Now, you can't audition the sounds from the Nord Sound Manager, but you have full access to them. And for the first time ever, the cache that was being used for storage of these files on your local computer to make the transfer back and forth quicker, it's now fully exposed and available to you so you can see right in the Nord Sound Manager what's in the cache and what isn't. This is so new that I wanted to throw up a couple of slides here that I think it's going to change the way we workflow this going forward. Let me explain. So let's take a look at a couple of problems that the brand new Nord Sound Manager solves. In the previous workflow, that would be versions prior to version 9, this is how things worked. You would go to the Nord website, you'd understand and audition the piano samples or the sound samples that you wanted to manipulate. You'd manually download those, and you'd have to engage your computer, downloads folder, desktop, wherever you like to work, and you had to kind of store and manage those downloads on your own with your own two hands. That required a little bit of computer skill, nothing too terribly difficult, but it was extra work. Then once you had those sounds downloaded, you would then open up the Nord Sound Manager and then import those sounds into the Nord Sound Manager so long as your keyboard was connected. Once the keyboard was connected, you could see and move the sounds, you could see the sizes, you could kind of understand the lay of the land. When you finally did move them to the Nord keyboard, then they would be stored in an invisible place. It's not actually invisible, but it was invisible from the perspective of the Nord Sound Manager, a place called a cache. The cache is a storage location for the pianos and for the samples. By storing the cache on your computer, the Nord Sound Manager has direct access to them. So an example of where you can really save time, if you were doing a full backup of, let's say, a Nord Stage 4, and this is your first time doing a backup to this computer, you'd click backup, and you'd have to wait roughly 60 or 70 minutes, maybe even more, depending on the speed of your computer, before all the files were pulled from the Nord keyboard onto the computer and then saved as a image, as a backup image, on your computer. That's about 70 minutes. However, the second time you do the backup, that's going to be much quicker, probably even less than a minute if you were to do a backup right after the first one, because all of those pianos and samples have now been stored in the cache on the computer, and they are accessible by the computer when it goes to do a backup, as for example. Then going forward, the cache has additional benefits. If I wanted to make a bundle of my favorite programs, those programs as a bundle would store both the piano and the samples. If they're in the cache already, then those bundles are going to be created almost immediately because they won't have to be pulled from the keyboard each and every time. The cache has access to that, and it's going to use the cache to make that bundle, especially for the big ticket items such as a large piano sample, which does take some time to move back and forth to the Nord keyboard. So the cache is the magic ingredient to keep things speedy and efficient when you're working with the Nord Sound Manager, especially if you're doing a lot of different configurations. So that was yesterday's workflow. As of today, we have a new workflow. We can start with the Nord Sound Manager on your computer. The Nord Sound Manager has a direct connect behind the scenes to the Nord website or to the Nord Cloud, whatever you want to call it, for your given keyboard. In fact, you can use the Nord Sound Manager without the keyboard connected Yes, you heard me right. You can use the Nord Sound Manager without the keyboard connected for certain features, such as viewing the library that's available to you, downloading selected library items, and storing them in the cache in anticipation for your next connection. And furthermore, you're not limited to a particular keyboard. You can just filter for one keyboard or the next. And you'll see that here in a minute when we take a first-hand look at the Nord Sound Manager. So, step one, open up the Nord Sound Manager. That directly connects to the Nord website. I have access to the complete and total library of sounds. It does create a cache. Then I can connect to my keyboard. Once the keyboard is connected, it then uses that cache to transfer the files back and forth between the keyboard and the computer. So this saves us the step of having to download the file, manage the file on our computer, get it over to the Nord Sound Manager manually, either by dragging or clicking a button. That's a lot of extra monkey business.
And then there's another new feature that I really like here. The Nord Sound Manager now auto-senses the operating system of the keyboard that it's connected to, determines if there's an update available, and makes that update available directly in the Nord Sound Manager. Here, for example, I've connected a Nord Wave 2. Here, the Nord Sound Manager says, update available, Nord Wave 2 OS version 1.24. I can get right to the update history here. It'll bring me to the website with a handy link. And I have the ability to immediately download the update right from the Nord Sound Manager by clicking download. Below, it indicates downloading the file update Nord Wave 2 1.24 complete. Within a few moments, you'll see that the button changes from download to install. So I'll click on that now, and it gives me this one last prompt. Do you want to exit Nord Sound Manager and launch the installer? I'll push OK. That will close the Nord Sound Manager and bring up the updater for my install, which I can install as I normally would. I'll double-click the installer now. It brings up the Nord Wave 2 OS update screen. It shows me that my current operating system is 1.22, and the one I'm about to install is 1.24. Now I can click Update, and my Nord Wave 2 will be updated. After that's complete, I can manually open the Nord Sound Manager and continue operations.
So now let's take a moment and download the Nord Sound Manager. We'll connect it to my Nord Stage 4, and we'll take a look at some of these features firsthand. So here I am on the Nord website, that's nordkeyboards.com. Just locate the software area and download the Nord Sound Manager. You can download it for Mac and or Windows. It will work with Windows 7 or above, and it'll work with Mac 10.1 or above as of this recording. It does not work on an iPad, a mobile device, a tablet. So I'll download this for the Mac, and I'll save that to a place that I can find it here on the desktop. There we go. So I will now install this. I'll double-click the install package and drag the Nord Sound Manager over into my applications folder. Once that's done, I can double-click that same folder and open it up directly. You'll note that it keeps the old Sound Manager there, and I'm going to keep it there in case I ever want to do a future comparison between old and new. But right now, I'll open up the brand new Nord Sound Manager. You might get this one-time screen, which is a security built into the Mac. Just click open. It's just ensuring that you know that you're about to open up a new program. Now, I already have my Nord keyboard connected, but let's really put this to the test, and I'm going to turn off my Nord keyboard right now. Okay, with the Nord keyboard off, much like previous versions of the Nord Sound Manager, the Nord Sound Manager becomes completely disabled. But not so in this new version. This new version does give me one feature over here called Sound Library. I can click on that, and I can actually pick any keyboard from the Nord family that is compatible with this version of the Nord Sound Manager, and I can detect and review the various sounds for a given keyboard. This is ahead of time before the keyboard is even connected. So for example, on my Nord Electro 6, it shows me the different library options I have for the piano library, and it categorizes them. Here are the grands, the uprights, EP tines, the layer, the mallet, electric grand, and so forth. And this sound library shows me quite a few things here. It shows me a column for the cache, which means that this file or this particular piano has been installed on the computer and exists on the computer, which means that when I go to use that particular piano, it's going to be very quick to transfer. For example, if I'm on the Nord keyboard and I'm making a bundle for something that includes the Electric Grand 3, that bundle will almost immediately be created because I have a cache for it. Now, if I select on something that isn't in the cache, such as Electric Grand 2, I have an option here that says Save to Offline Cache. And when I click on that,
It will talk to the Nord website and immediately start downloading it for me, even without the keyboard connected. So now the Electric Grand 2 is available to me in the cache area, and that makes it easy and readily available to work with on the Nord keyboard. So I'll keep that there for now. Then I have the same set of options under the sample library. Let me quickly go over the differences between what a piano sample might be and a sample from the sample library. The piano samples or sounds are available to a Nord keyboard so long as it has a piano engine. If your Nord keyboard doesn't have a piano engine, then you won't even see this option appear once the keyboard is connected. An example of this would be the Nord Lead A1. That keyboard has no piano engine, so you won't ever be downloading or worried about piano samples or anything from the piano library. The samples are pertinent to Nord keyboards that have a synth engine. That would include the Electro, the Stage series, and the Wave series. It also includes the Piano series and the Grand series. Here again, the Lead A1 has no such ability to play samples in the synth engine, so this would not pertain to a Nord Lead A1. The other difference here is for piano samples, as of this recording, there is no way for you to make your own piano samples that can be played in the piano engine. Those always come from Nord. They are hard-coded. They're not editable in any way. You can't make your own sample of a piano and play it in the piano engine. However, with that said, you can make your own samples and have that available to the synth engine for playback. And that's the difference between these two. The sample library has both sounds that come from Nord that they make themselves, but you are free to make your own samples or get some in the marketplace. Okay, now let's connect the Nord Stage 4. Now, you'll note that once the synchronization is complete, the Nord Sound Manager automatically navigates you over to the program area by default and then makes all these other options available here at the top. Now, these other options at the top, although their icons have changed from previous versions of the Nord Sound Manager, their functionality remains the same. So I won't be going over info and dual view and organize and auto select and all the other features because I've got a lot of videos online for that already. But I do want to talk about this sound library and how it relates to the keyboard itself. So if I click on piano and sound library, I now get two screens side by side. And you have to pay close attention to these headers because without that, you won't really have a firm understanding of what you're looking at. On the left side is the sound library. Everything on this list is the available sound library to you right now as a Nord owner of, in this case, a Nord Stage 4. The difference between the cache indicator and those without a cache indicator simply means that these are available, they're in the cloud on the Nord website, but they're currently not downloaded to your computer. That's the only difference between this icon and not. Now you have an icon right next to it, which is another handy indicator, which indicates, is it on the Nord Stage 4 right now? So looking at both of these icons tell you where you are. You'll also notice that there are size indicators when you select on a piano where it shows you the anticipated size of a given piano, and once it's selected, it shows you whether it's in the cache or on the keyboard. So for example, I have the Velvet Grand selected. It's showing me that the large is installed, but I can click on extra large. It will indicate the size here and here, but it isn't in the cache and it's not installed in the keyboard. Then the other filters for medium and small are available. So for the first time ever, we can sort of see exactly how big these pianos are going to be, and it's a lot easier to manage here in the Nord Sound Manager rather than always shuffling back and forth between the website and the computer. It also makes it a tad easier to manage the limited memory on a Nord keyboard, so you can figure out which pianos you're going to be removing or reducing in size in order to make room for newer and or bigger pianos. So here I have the usual buttons to transfer to the instrument, or I can substitute a given piano, or I can save the sounds to the cache, which you already saw prior to the keyboard being connected. The same rules apply for the sample library. The only difference here is that you get a sample with its listed size here. You don't necessarily need to choose between extra large, large, medium, and small, because the samples don't work like that. And in addition, they are generally much smaller than any of the pianos. It is very handy now to have all the available samples here on this list and categorized by category without having to go back and forth to the Nord website. Now, I haven't mentioned it yet in this video, but there's an option here to show downloads, and this will be a list of everything you've downloaded for this one session. It's sort of a breadcrumb of the history of what you've done. Much like a browser would do, where if you downloaded a bunch of files from the internet, the browser would indicate which files were recently downloaded. And you have an option here to clear that as well. So I'll clear that now. So I hope this video helped orient you around the Nord Sound Manager version 9. I'm sure Nord will continue to modify it as time goes on. Thanks for joining me on this video, and we'll catch you on the next one.